Hello, dearest friends, how are you? So, because the situation in Israel and all around the world, I decided to do daily Zohar reading. Every day to read a little bit from the Zohar. And the purpose is to connect every soul, every human being in the world to the light of the Zohar. It says that the light of the Zohar is the light of love and mercy. What we need in our life is mercy. When we are merciful, we're drawing mercy from the upper world. The Zohar helps us to open our heart, to be merciful and kind, and to respect every human being. And then all the light force of God, all the blessings of God, can rest in our life. So every day I'll try to read something from the Zohar. If you can, please send this message to other people. Help them to be, to join the WhatsApp group, this Facebook group. So every person can at least once a day read or listen just for a few minutes from the Zohar. So the light of love of God can penetrate through and enter the heart of every human being, to open wide the heart so every human being can love each other unconditionally. So I am opening the Zohar right now on the portion of Noah, which is the portion this week. We know that every week there's like a portion from the Bible that we read. There's a message from God for all humanity. And we will read something from the Zohar of portion Noah, verse 163. I'll read first of all the Aramaic, because when we're reading the Aramaic, we actually shining our soul. We're cleaning our soul from anger, from frustration, from anxieties. We're cleaning our soul from fears and from envy and jealousy and all the rest of the things. And we are charging our soul with endless love. Read the Aramaic. ודלא השתלים כסתיו, אלא בחובה דחמאס. דאבו מקפחים דלדה, דאבו בישים לשמיים לבריאות. תחת זיקם הינון ממנן מלעילה. פקדן על כלי דינון מסרי דינה על חברון. על מה דאבדילון? דכתיב כי מלאך הארץ חמאס מפניהם. בגין כך כתיב, הנה משחיתה מת הארץ. It's interesting that if you open the Bible this week, you'll see that in the beginning it says that the people in the time of Noah, in the generation of Noah, which was the generation of the flood, they behaved with negative energy that the Torah calls it Hamas, like the Hamas of today. And Hamas is a word in Hebrew, actually, which actually representing a very evil energy. That's what the Zohar explains. And the Zohar says that the people in the generation of Noah were behaving toward each other with Hamas, which means what? Means that they were evil to each other. That's what the Zohar says. They were evil to each other, and they were also evil to God. They were negative to the to other people and negative to the Creator. And it says, "Bo ekama memunim im lemal hashimtmanu al kolot shel mosrei din al chaverim leshamayim." And they did a lot of things, but one of the things that they did, they spoke bad about other people. They tried to find what's negative, what's wrong, what's bad. They tried to kind of find the negative things that people did, and to speak about it and to empower it, and that's what the Zohar says, that that's brought the energy of Hamas. And what we can learn from it is that in life, all of us, we have people around us that behave in certain kind of behavior that sometimes it's egoistic, sometimes it's not pure love, let's say. And the question is, like, what we're focusing on. Like, can we make effort to focus on what's good about that person, or just the fact that the person have something that it's not 100% kind of according to way that we would like. We right away judging them, speaking bad about them, and focus on, you know, what's wrong about them. It says that the people of generation of Noah, that's how they behave toward each other. They were all the time talking bad about each other. They were all the time kind of find what's wrong with each other. And it created such a negative energy that created the destruction, created the flood. It's not that God decided that the flood gonna come. It's just the negative energy that they created actually brought chaos upon themselves. And what's the name of that energy? And the Zohar calls it, the Torah calls it Hamas. When we not kind to each other, when we thinking and focusing on what's wrong and speaking about what's bad about the other person instead of finding what's good within the other person and you know, empowering it. So we actually, God forbid, we empowering the darkness. We need to be careful from it. Okay. And we'll read just a little bit more. So it says about Noah, come and see. I'm on verse 166. Ki otcha ra'iti. Noah, even though he built the flood for all those years, like for you know, something like 120 years, he built the ark, right? But he didn't enter the ark. You could say, okay, he built the ark for all those years, you know, and the rain start to, you know, the rain starts, means the flood start to happen. He could just say to his family, let's go to the ark. He built the ark. No, he's standing outside and waiting God to invite him. Sometimes the way that we look at life, it's we think that life belongs to us. Our house belongs to us. This belongs to me. My car belongs to me. Nothing belongs to us. Nothing. Even if we worked for it and we earned it and we, you know, going to work and we making money, whatever, you know, and we brought to this life our children and we got education and we have a profession, doesn't matter. Nothing belongs to you. Nothing. Everything you need to, the correct way to live in this world is to feel that you are a guest. And a guest don't just enter the house of his neighbor or a friend. He's waiting for the other person to invite him and only then he enters. Noah, even though the flood started, but he's not entering. Why? Because he's waiting for God to actually invite him to come into the ark. That's the other people in that generation, they didn't behave like that. They were just stealing and taking. You don't have to be a thief in order to steal. Sometime in life, you just like we, all of us, we're just taking. We're thinking that this, the fact that I have food on my table, it's belong to me. Nothing belong to you. You always in life supposed to feel, wow, it's not for granted. It's like to take the moment to appreciate, to actually thank the Creator, means to be grateful. That's the idea, to be grateful and to wait God to invite you. Don't just go and take and behave like everything belongs to you. And if you behave like that, you always will be able to have everything because you have modesty. You are humble. You realize that God is the owner here and you are the guest. So you'll be able to enjoy so much more from life. And that's how Noah behaved. The opposite of the people in his generation, right? So it says, Boe, I'm reading on 166 on portion Noah. It says, Boe, ma ketuv ki otcha ra'iti tzadik. God look at Noah and talk to him. And God says, you are righteous among all those, wicked people. Again, in Hebrew, the word wicked it's the same word, the same initials of desire to receive for the self alone. So evil people, it's not necessarily someone that is like a robber or a murderer. An evil person is just someone, and again, we're not pure evil and we're not pure righteous. We're all somewhere in the between. But we're here to improve ourselves, right? So, but evil means thinking about taking constantly. That the consciousness is about taking. But from the other hand, righteousness means God says to Noah, you are righteous. What does it mean, righteousness? Righteousness, righteous is a person that realizes that I'm here to give. I'm not here to take. Because I'm giving, God will give me. But that's not, you know, yes, I want to receive, I want to enjoy. Of course, I do. But I don't come with, you know, I'm forcing God to give me. I'm humble. If God wants to give me, it's good. And if not, it's also good. I'm here, I'm a guest, you know. And that's how Noah behaved, you know, with righteousness. He was righteous. God tells him, you are righteous among the people. מכאן למדנו שלא יקבל אדם אורח לביתו אם הוא חושד בו שהוא רשע, אלא אם כן שהוא נחשב בעיניו לצדיק ואינו חושד בעיניו כלל. זה שגדול בו אתה וכל ביתך אל הטבע מעטה משום כי אותך ראיתי צדיק לפניי בדור הזה. אוקיי. משום שאם למדנו שאם נותן לו לאורך מלבד רשות, לא ניתן רשות לכל באים עם האורך, להכניסם לבית. זה שגבו אותם וכל בית חי לבית הבא, שאני כולם נתן רשות להיכנס מגלל זה, למדנו סוד סדרי דרך ארץ. Zohar says that don't just invite every person into your house. Make sure that the people that you invite into your house, they come in with consciousness of sharing, because if you invite someone to your house and they come in with consciousness of taking, it can suck away the energy from the house. So obviously we don't want to offend no one, and we don't want to tell someone you are not righteous or something like that. But consciousness generally needs to be that the person, people that you invite to your house, and the energy that you would like to welcome into your house, it's energy of sharing. If you invite someone to your house which coming with consciousness of taking, it's not good for your energy. It's not good for the energy of the house. And that's why God makes sure that only, Noah entered the ark, because God looked at Noah and he checks him and he realized that he's a righteous, means he's coming with consciousness of sharing, and say, okay, now you can enter. Now you can enter, you know. And but once you allow your guest to enter, the Zohar says, you need to also allow all the people that come with that guest. You don't just check every person. Once you checked the main guest, if he comes with his family and friends, everyone is welcome. The same way that God tells Noah, you can come in, and now all your family can come in, and all the, you know, everyone that comes with you. And the Zohar tells us how, from the way that God behaves toward Noah, we can also learn from it to our personal life, the way that we inviting people to our, not just to our house, to enter into our life, basically. So basically, that's a short message from the Zohar. I'm very happy that you joined. It's very important, you know. It says in the Zohar, 2,000 years ago, Rabbi Shimon Baruch Hai says, there's going to be a time. The Zohar actually describes exactly what's happening right now in Israel and in the Middle East. The Zohar says that it's preparing the world for the new era, for the era of Mashiach, Messiah, which is the time of redemption. And the Zohar says that in this time, it's going to be not easy in the world. And the Zohar says that the vaccination, what we can do is to read Zohar. When we're learning from Zohar, we actually allow ourselves to purify our heart, to awake mercy in our consciousness, in our heart. When a person behaves with mercy, with love, with tolerance, he's creating a protection shield around him. That's why I created this kind of group of daily Zohar reading, so every human being in the world can join us for a few minutes Zohar. So every person in the world can awake in their life the energy of mercy. And collectively, we're affecting the entire world. So thank you for joining us, and please welcome other people to join also the Facebook group, also the WhatsApp group of the daily Zohar reading. Thank you, wishing you well and blessings, miracles. Please pray for Israel. We need all the support of all the people of the world. It's not just for Israel, it's for the Middle East. It's Israel, it's the heart, spiritual heart of the world. When you pray for Israel and when you want blessing to happen here, you're actually supporting the entire world. You're helping the entire world to stay balanced and positive. So thank you very much, everyone, and lots of love.